right? So today's topic, we are now going to calculate the order of a reaction, right? We had classified the reactions into zero order, first order and second order, okay? And we also discussed that order is what? It is experimentally determined powers of each concentration in the rate law expression. So that what order was. Now when we had given in the previous lecture, in the previous class, we had taken many graphs. First order ka kis tarah se ban raha hai, second ka kaise ban raha hai, third ka kaise ban raha hai, zero order ka kaise ban raha hai. So we had given graphical representations and with the help of those graphs, we were manipulating or we were calculating the order of the reaction. But the only drawback which the scientists or we face while calculating the order of a reaction through graphical method is that over there we can only calculate the order of a reaction where one type of reactant is present. If more than one type of reactant is present, we are not able to calculate the order of a reaction. For that, we have to use this method which is known as the initial rate method. Generally, what we do in initial rate method is, this is again a totally experimental data, experimentally verified or calculated method. And for that, what we do is that we take the ratios of rates at different times. Okay, so in this initial rate method, the order of the reaction is manipulated according to the data of the rate and the concentrations given. Clear? So this is a very easy and a very, you can say, accurate method to calculate the order of the reaction. We will explain it with the help of an example. We are taking the experimental data, right? We are taking the experimental data for the reaction. We have been given a reaction 2A plus B2 to give 2AB. This is the reaction given to us, right? And the experimental data, we have recorded three readings over here. This is concentration of A, this is concentration of B, and with that we calculate the rate. Okay. Now when the concentration of A, that is 0.50, okay, and the concentration of B, that is also 0.50, the rate of the reaction is 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 4. ठीक है, फिर उसके बाद जब A becomes equal to 0.50, B becomes equal to 1.00, then in that case the rate of the reaction given to us is 3.2 into 10 raised to power minus 4. Right? And then when the concentration of A becomes equal to 1 and the concentration of B2 becomes equal to 1, okay, then the rate of the reaction that is given as 3.2 into 10 raised to power minus 4, right? Now when we are looking at the data, what we can say over here is that when the concentration of A is same, right, the rate over here that is becoming double. When the concentration of A is same, the rate over here is becoming double. Okay? And when the concentration of B is same, the rate also does not change. The rate also is the same. Keeping this in mind, what we can say over here is that the rate of the reaction that can be given as K is equal to, rate is equal to K into concentration of A0 into B. That means that the rate is independent of the concentration of A, whereas the rate is directly proportional to the concentration of B. This can also be done by taking the ratio. Okay, so when we are taking the ratio of this, We take the ratio, first of all, we will take the ratio over here. Where 0.50 and 0.50, that is equal to same. And when the rate is changing over here, then the concentration of B is changing over here, then the rate is becoming double. Similarly, RPP concentration ko kya ho raha hai? It is increasing two times, 0.50 into 2, that is equal to 1.0. Theek hai? So because this is also increasing two times and this is also increasing two times, therefore it is directly proportional to the concentration of P. But when we are talking of A, over here the concentration of A, that is 0.50, over here the concentration of A, that is equal to 1. But when we are looking at the rates do not change. Therefore, the rate is independent of the concentration of A. Okay? So we say that rate is equal to K into concentration of A raised to power 0 because it is independent of the concentration of A and is equal to concentration of B. So this is how we can calculate. So we say that rate with respect to A, that is equal to 0. Okay? And rate with respect to B, that is equal to 1. So the total order of the reaction, because order with respect to A is 0 over here and order with respect to B is 1 over there, so total order that will be equal to 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. Okay? So this is the initial rate method to calculate order of the reaction. Clear? Fir uske baad, the order of the reaction also depends upon rate mechanism. ठीक है, हमने पढ़ा था कि रेट मैकेनिज्म का मतलब कि जो स्लोएस्ट स्टेप होगा इन एनी मैकेनिज्म दैट इज गोइंग टू बी द रेट डिटरमिनिंग स्टेप, राइट? लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ वी आर टेकिंग इनटू कंसीडरेशन अ रिएक्शन 2NO प्लस Br2 टू गिव 2NOBr, दिस इज आवर रिएक्शन. व्हेन वी लुकिंग एट द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ द रिएक्शन, the mechanism of the reaction, that is in the first step NO combines with Br2 to give us NOBr2. ठीक है, and in the second step it is NOBr2 plus NO to give us 2NOBr. This is a fast reaction and this is a slow reaction. So if you are looking at the overall reaction over here, overall reaction that is going to be equal to what? NOBr2 and NOBr2 gets cancelled over here. We have NO plus NO, that is 2NO plus Br2 to give us 2NOBr. ठीक है? Now when we are looking at the mechanism of the reaction, the rate of the reaction should be given according to the slow step. So rate according to this should be given as K into concentration of NOBr2 into concentration of NO. ठीक है, but as you can see that in the overall reaction there is no NOBr2 present. Okay, so concentration of NOBr2 that is given as what? In the overall reaction there is no NOBr2 present, na? So we say that the concentration of NOBr2 that is given as what? That is given as concentration of into concentration of Br2, and let's say that this is K dash, okay, and over here we are putting K double dash, right? Now taking into consideration both of these, what do we get? The rate that should be equal to, put the value of NO, concentration of NO, Br2 from here. So we will have rate is equal to K dash into K double dash into concentration of NO into concentration of Br2 into concentration of NO. Okay? Now KK dash, that is equal to the rate, total rate constant. So rate that will become equal to K into concentration of NO ka square concentration of Br2. So the order of this reaction, that is going to be equal to 3. 2 with respect to NO and 1 with respect to Br2. Right? So we are talking of order of reactions over here. Let's study in detail each type of order of reaction. So first we will go on to zero order reaction. Okay? Understood? Okay. Right? So what do we have over here? The next is reactions of various orders. Reactions of various orders. The first one, that is zero order reaction. Now, what is zero order reaction? Zero order reaction means that the rate is independent of the concentration of the reactant, which means that rate does not depend upon the concentration of the reactants. For example, if we have this reaction, A2 products, zero order reaction means that rate is equal to K into concentration of A raised to power naught. Theek hai? Okay. Now in this case, if we want to take the this rate in the differential equation which we had done when we started the chapter. So over here, we can say that minus dA upon dP, that is equal to K into concentration of A naught. Okay. Now let's find out the integrated expression, which is generally used for numerical purposes. Integrated expression for zero order reaction, take it into consideration equation number 1. Okay. So integrating both sides, what will we get? Minus D into concentration of A. Let's take this dT that side. A naught over here has no significance at all. So minus dA, that is equal to KdT. ठीक है? Or minus dA, if you are taking the differential equation. So minus A, that is going to be equal to KT plus I. Right, where I, that is the integration constant. Okay, now let's say that at time t is equal to 0, the concentration of the reactant is taken as A naught. Okay, so at time t is equal to 0, this equation will become minus A naught, that is equal to KT, will become equal to 0 over here. Because time is 0, so K into T, that is going to be equal to 0. So minus E naught, that becomes equal to I. Okay? Substituting the value of I in the second equation. We will substitute the value of I from here in the second equation. We will have minus concentration of A, that is equal to KT minus concentration of A naught. Okay, let's get A naught on that side. So we have A naught minus concentration of A, that is equal to KT. So this is the integrated rate law expression for zero order reaction. Right? So if we are talking of zero order reaction, we say there are certain photochemical reactions which behave as zero order. For example, combination of H2 and Cl2 in presence of H2 to give 2HCl. This behaves as a zero order reaction because the order that is independent of concentration of both hydrogen and chlorine. So the rate of this that can be expressed as K into concentration of H2 raised to power 0, concentration of Cl2 raised to power 0. Okay? Similarly, decomposition of N2O. Decomposition of N2O, that is NO2 plus half O2. Right? So, yahan pe bhi the rate that is independent of concentration of N2O. So, we can represent it as K into concentration of N2O raised to power 0. Clear? So, when we are looking at the characteristics of zero order reaction, the unit of zero order reaction, please remember that this is another factor by which you can, this is a very very important point, that the unit of the rate constant, that is also going to help us to manipulate the order of the reaction, because the unit of rate constant depends upon order of reaction. Okay, so let's derive the unit of K for zero order reaction. Okay, so let's go back to this expression over here, minus df on dt, that is equal to K into A naught. Okay, so we have minus dA upon dt, that is equal to K into concentration of A naught. A naught has no significance. The units of concentration, that is going to be moles per liter, and concentration of time, the unit of time, that is second, inverse. So whenever the value of K is given to you in the question, that this is the value of K, moles per liter per second, what is the order of the reaction? Then you have to manipulate the order of the reaction on the basis of the units of rate constant. Okay? So if the units of rate constant is given to you as moles per liter per second, then that means it is zero order reaction. Okay? Phir uske baad, let's go on to the first order reaction. First order reaction. First order reaction, same we are taking a hypothetical reaction A to give us products. Okay, so the rate of the above reaction, that will be given as what? K into concentration of A raised to power 1, because it is a first order reaction. Now let's take the differential rate equation over here. So we will have minus dA upon dt, that is equal to K into concentration of A. In order to get the integrated rate law expression, we have to integrate these terms. So we get the like terms together. We have minus D into concentration of A upon concentration of A, that is equal to KdT. Integrating on both sides, we will have minus D into concentration of A upon concentration of A, that is equal to K into dT. ठीक है? अब क्या कहते हैं उसको? Integrating both sides, we've got this. Now, in order to calculate this, what we will get is natural log of concentration of A, that is equal to Kt plus I, right? So let's say this is equation number 1. Okay, now at time t is equal to 0, concentration of A, that will become equal to A naught. Okay, so putting in the values, what will we get? Minus natural log of A naught, that is equal to again K into 0. 0, that is equal to I. Okay. Now putting the value of I in equation number 1, what will we get? We will get minus natural log of A, that is equal to KT minus natural log of A naught. Let's take A naught this side. So we have natural log of A naught minus natural log of A, that is equal to KT. Okay. Now this can also be written as natural log of A naught upon A, that is equal to KT. ठीक है, natural log को logs में convert करते हैं, 2.303 log of 10, log base 10, concentration of that is equal to KT. So this is the integrated rate law expression which we are going to use for our numericals. Okay? Now let's say that the initial concentration of the reactant that is equal to A. Okay? And after time T, X of A gets dissociated. So what is the final concentration that is equal to A minus X? So ye jo A minus X hai, that is the left reactant, the reactant which is left behind. Okay, because in such numericals you generally get confused what has to be taken in the denominator over here. So this is the reactant which is left behind after dissociation. ठीक है, so यहाँ पे ये हमारे पास क्या आ जाएगा, 2.303 log of A upon A minus X, that is equal to KT. ठीक है, X is कि कितना dissociate हुआ है, that is going to be X. Okay, so this is known as the kinetic equation for first order reaction. Clear? Now over here you have to remember that number one, even if we are changing the units of concentration, like we can take moles for per liter over here, or we can take decimeter cube or whatever, whatever the unit of concentration which we are taking over here, the value of K, that is not going to change. So the value of K over here, that is going to be unit independent. ठीक है, so whatever concentration आप ले रहे हो उसकी क्या कहते हैं उसको, concentration की कोई भी unit लोगे, value of K that will not change. ठीक है, then what is going to be the half life period of such reactions, for first order reactions? Half life basically means what? Half life period is the time when concentration of the reactant becomes half. ठीक है, so जब concentration half रह जाती है, मतलब half of the reactant has been consumed, then that is known as the half life period. Now let's say that over here the value of A, that is equal to what initial concentration we are taking over here. ठीक है, so value of A हम लोग ले लेते हैं कितना, alright, let's take the value of X as 0.5 A. X is 50% of A dissociated. So if we are taking X over here, let's say that X is equal to, if 50% dissociated, then 50 upon 100 into A. Hana? That is going to be X. Right? So upar wali equation will aapki kya aa jayegi? That is going to be 2.303. Yeah, let's say total A minus X as 0.58. Then it will come more accurate. So KT that will be equal to, now over here T can be denoted by T half, because it is the time when 50% of completion of the reaction has taken place, so half time. So KT half, that is equal to 2.303 log of A upon 0.5 minus A, sorry, 0.5 A. ठीक है, so A और A cancel हो गया, 0.5, 1 upon 0.5 that is equal to 2. ठीक है, so this will become equal to 2.303 log of 2. The value of log of 2, that is 0.3090, therefore this will become equal to 2.303 into 0.3010. ठीक है, so ये क्या आ जाता है हमारा, KT half, that is equal to 0.693. when you multiply this, it comes to 0.693, or T half, that is equal to 0.693 upon K. So this is the half life period for first order reaction, and as you can see from the equation, it is independent of concentration of the reactants, right? So half life period for first order reaction does not depend upon the concentration of the reactants. ठीक है, clear? So let's go on to examples of first order. Examples of first order. The first example is decomposition of hydrogen peroxide. Half of O2. So rate for this will be written as, rate is equal to K into concentration of H2O2. ठीक है, सेकेंड हमारे पास है हाइड्रोलिसिस ऑफ एसीटोन. दिस इज अ सीटो फर्स्ट ऑर्डर रिएक्शन, हाइड्रोलिसिस रिएक्शन है. तो हमने पढ़ा था कि जो हाइड्रोलिसिस रिएक्शन होता है, दैट इज अ सीटो फर्स्ट ऑर्डर रिएक्शन. Now, there is another very very important concept which we are going to take over here. Ki if in case, in the questions, gases has been given. Okay. So, for that, the pressure would be given to you. So, instead of concentration, pressure is used. जैसे हम लोग ले रहे हैं क्या, ऊपर ले रहे हैं हम लोग कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, इनिशियल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ए, एंड बिलो वी आर टेकिंग द फाइनल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. सो ओवर हियर आल्सो इन द न्यूमरेटर यू विल टेक द इनिशियल प्रेशर, एंड इन द डिनोमिनेटर यू विल टेक द फाइनल प्रेशर. ठीक है, सो लेट्स जस्ट टेक एन एग्जाम्पल ओवर हियर. लाइक इफ प्रेशर इज गिवन इन गैसियस रिएक्शंस, देन व्हाट इज गोइंग टू बी द रेट फॉर फर्स्ट ऑर्डर रिएक्शन, rate that is going to be equal to 2.T log of initial pressure P naught upon P naught minus X. ठीक है, where P is the pressure of the reactant at the initial stage, and P naught minus X, that is the pressure at time t. ठीक है, P naught minus X, that is the pressure at time t. Got it? Now let's say we have an hypothetical reaction over here, A to give us B plus C plus D. ठीक है, now initially all are in gaseous state. Initially what is going to happen, that the pressure will be only due to A, right, because rest of the gases, they are not formed. So at initial stage, the pressure due to all these gases, that is going to be equal to zero. At time t, we are saying that the pressure that becomes equal to what? P naught minus x, that is what we have written over here. So, at time t, the pressure is going to be P naught minus x. Yahan pe x, aur yahan pe x. Theek hai? Now, what is going to be the P total at time t? That will be P naught minus x plus x plus x and plus x. Theek hai? So, over here, this and this gets cancelled. So, this is how you need to find the P total. It will become equal to P naught plus 2x. It is not essential that the question will be given to you in a similar manner. There may be two products also. Okay? So, but you have to calculate the P total in this manner. Is it clear? Okay. What is going to be the final pressure now? Once all the reaction is complete, then the final pressure, that will be equal to the pressure due to A, that will now become equal to zero. Because A has been totally consumed. And the pressure would be P naught. Right? Because the pressure will be due to B, C and D. Have you understood? Okay. Now over here, we are considering that, let's consider that over here, there were different kind of moles. Okay? There are different kind of moles, A, B, C and D. All are different kind of moles. Okay. Phir uske baad hamare paas kya aa jata hai? After this, if we are taking an example, in which the number of mole of reactants, that is equal to number of mole of products, SOCl2, to give us SO2 plus Cl2. So over here you can see there is one mole of SO2 Cl2, one mole of SO2 and one mole of Cl2. So number of moles in this case, all they are going to be same. ठीक है, so यहाँ पे हमारे पास क्या आ जाएगा? We are going to use a special equation. K is equal to 2.303 upon t log of initial pressure, which is represented by pi, right? Upon Pi minus P total. But this is only true if the number of moles in the reactants and products that is going to be same. If there are one number of moles over here, okay, but here it would have been two. So one and two, then you have to use this method. You need to calculate P total by the above method. Okay? Have you understood? Okay. Phir uske baad, first, what do we understand by another term, which is first order growth kinetics. What is first order growth kinetics? This method is generally used for population growth and bacteria multiplication. Okay? Population growth and bacteria multiplication. Now in this case, let's say that we have time and we have certain population. Okay? So we say that at time 0 the population, that is equal to A. Now with time the population will grow, whereas when we were talking of reactants, there was a decrease in reactants. Okay? So over here at time dt, let's say at a very small change in time, the population that becomes equal to A plus S. Okay? So over here, dx upon dt, that will be directly proportional to A plus S. Right? The rate will be directly proportional to the concentration as we have been doing. So over here, we are just taking the population or the multiplication of bacteria. Okay? So we can also write that dx upon dt that is equal to k into a plus x, right? And if we are getting the like terms together, we will get dx upon a plus x that is equal to k dt, right? So solving this now, what we will get? Solving this, we will get k is equal to minus 2.303 upon t log of a upon a plus x. Instead of a minus x, what are we taking over here? We are taking a plus x. ठीक है? Clear हो गया? Alright. Now, अगर हमें volumes दे रखी है, we have a case study over here, कि हमें बोला है कि kinetics calculate करना है, और हमें volumes दे रखी है, reagents की. Instead of concentration and pressure. हमने concentration कर ली, फिर उसके बाद हमने pressure भी कर लिया, अब हम लोग calculate करते हैं, अगर हमें volumes दी है. So, volumes में हमारे पास K आ जाएगा, 2.303 into t log of v infinity minus v0 upon v infinity minus vt. So let's understand the terms kya kya hai. V infinity is the volume used at infinite time. This will be given to you in the question. ठीक है? So v infinity is the volume at infinite time. V0 that is the volume used at 0 time and Vt is the volume used at time t. ठीक है? Now अगर हमें V0 नहीं दिया है, अगर V0 नहीं दिया, तो ऊपर वाली equation फिर क्या आ जाएगी? K is equal to 2.303 upon t log of V0 is not given to us, V infinity upon V infinity minus Vt. This is if V0 or V0 is not given to us. Second, if V infinity is not given to us. ठीक है? तो अगर V infinity हमें नहीं दे रखी होगी, तो ऊपर वाला क्या हो जाएगा? K is equal to 2.303 upon T log of V infinity is not given to us. V0 upon Vt. V0 upon Vt. ठीक है? Is it clear? So, this is our first order reaction. Now, in this chapter, we are left with second order reaction and a lot of questions. We have to discuss at least 20 questions from this chapter so that because from this chapter, one numerical definitely comes. Okay, so we will do a lot of questions after the completion of our second order and we go to the next chapter then surface chemistry. Okay?